Hello. your team. You take those spots.
Yeah. Thank you. So I guess warm-ups have to be manually, yeah.
Yeah.
I should contribute to Hivemind more.
What?
I should contribute more to Hivemind. It's fun. And my problem is that I do code all day at work, and I'll let you,
No, go ahead.
I feel like I code all day at work, so it's like, I want to do Hivemind stuff more than I want to do my work, but I'm like so code exhausted by that point.
Yeah. Yeah, it makes it kind of hard.
Well, just like, I don't want to either have to, either, I guess, wait to start or manually reset the score after the warm up.
See Billy on blue, we've got Alex and Joe, we've got a warm-up happening right now.
I
Steen, Sean Creel from Baltimore, Washington, and the Strokes. Cass on the ground. She's Reagan and Jose Alonso. On the goal, we've got Jack. We've got Dan Billy on the Caps. Alex Hogan and Bolundo and Marie, both from Baltimore. So far, it's still in the Snail is in the net, and that's not going to be stopped. Alex takes a day map. Back on the squad. And some Warriors high. Looks like they're committing to the berries now. They've got all tops in and four bottoms. Blue has all three of their Warriors edging at the moment, so that's going to be tough. There's a bounce and a kick in. Three berries left for Gold, and Gold Abs takes out Blue Abs. That's responded by Gold Abs. Who's got the snail past mid? But got still only 3 berries left for Brawl. So it's a long way to go on that snail, and we're gonna have to ledge for a very long time. Just decides to bury him, why not? And now they're back on snow. Gold boosters. Or right into the queen. The entire blue team within 5 seconds. And then dies to blue queen. Last berry. So, threatening to come in. Here it comes. And had to dive to prevent that. So Alex now up 2 hours. Hello to everyone in chat. This is Alex. Up 2-0 Billy from DC. Billy wants to go to Nightmare now. What's the hell is this? What's that? Truly stacks of speeds, but Billy bumps them out of there.
Thank you. o'clock, by the way.
Hello everyone, my name is Orlando. I'm a Daphne and Sebastian. We also have my wife here. May or may not. She's signaling now, so I guess she won't be commenting. I guess we're just going to have to listen to my voice only, so I apologize for that. You feel free to mute.
So we've got a zero out the scores there.
No.
Who's in Mozilla, Firefox?
Just doing some text stuff right now before.
So just literally just type zero.
What tab is that? In the Firefox?
Yeah. Firefox here. And then we're gonna
update that's updating.
If it doesn't like naturally update, just like.
And then how do I get back to the screen?
Is
it this tab?
Yeah, keep
close. Yeah. Close.
I don't know.
Okay.
You said close.
Yes.
And then if you go
close.
You can edit the cap if you need to.
Is it right here?
Just leave it.
So a little bit of life here, if they can get both
still needing to get Warriors back up, just have old ass. So both of them are battling it out. Old Strike joins the party. Trying to get that control, try to get it back in, but Lou's doing a good job of it.
Oh no.
You have old ass kind of camping the net right there. So, and a lot of chrome bopping. So clean trades there, but now the net's open for Bold. They got blue checkers there, and okay, they're battling there, but alright, a lot of deaths there. It looks like blue is gonna be set here again. And now the blue queen is trapped with no hits, so that would be it. So Bold picks up their first win on day. So this is a best of three format where the loser gets to pick. So not necessarily gonna be nightmare based. Yeah, definitely a good skull. Military kills, that's pretty good. What do you think of that match? Good, okay. Oh, it looks like they do choose Knight, so we'll have a normal progression so far. Blue opens high, Gold opens low. Oh, Blue tries to go into the dive but can't quite make it. So they get some really loss there. Blue Skull does some work and takes out two Warriors. Still they got Gold abs left and they're getting one back up. But early snail pressure out of the gate with Blue after that early death, so nice comeback there to reset.
Maybe a runner.
All right, so three Warriors up for Bold. Blue's still looking to get one of theirs up. It does a nice clear around the mid, so they'll get one back up. Oh, Bold Strikes manages to deny that blue top. So still looking for the rest of their team to get up here. Oh, a risky crossover, but manages to make it through.
Blue is on last year.
Oh, Blue Skull making some plays here, trying to help stabilize this match. All right, so Gold on last year versus Gold Team up. Now they're down to two Warriors for Blue. A lot of contesting here in mid, trying to get up. A nice block under the queens by Blue Abs. Oh, and a nice kill by Blue Abs again here. Just good mid control. So, but, oh, a quick double kill by Blue Abs. Wow, that's crazy. So they're both on last now. And now Blue Snail is getting past the Blue Waterfall, just shy of it, got picked off. So both queens on last here, have to be careful. Blue looking good. Looks like Gold's down to one Warrior. Little risky moves, making some risky walks under, but manages to make it through.
Oh, there.
Another pickoff there. Gold is wiped, and Blue Checkers is denying right gate. So right now, looks like that snail's trying to move in, but the queen gets in a bad spot and gets pinned. Blue Abs manages to get the final kill here, and it's a comeback win for Daphne. So now it's 1-1. Really good match. A little bit of a shaky start for Blue with that early death, but managed to stabilize. Wow, I gotta say, Blue Abs with a quick double kill within like 10 seconds. That's a way to bring the match around. Oh, that's Connor on Blue Abs. It's kind of expected. He's really good. I just looked over now. I'm like, who is Blue Abs? It makes a lot of sense now. Alright, so going to Dust now. We'll guarantee to see a fourth map. Gold went for the bump, but no one did a contest. A little awkward there. Getting psyched out, but Gold finally managed to get one up in mid. Ooh, an early speed kill on Gold. Blue Connor again. That's a nice early pick there. Zone coverage right now. Blue seconds trying to keep the snail in check. Oh. One warrior down. She couldn't get up in time. So we got two warriors for one. It looks like. Bull's looking for one to get up on left. They got a speed run. Lou nearly brought the snail back to mid, but gets picked off again, so slightly on the right side. Back up on right. Blue's slowly riding, but she's still near mid, so not much movement there. It's a lot of positional strategy right now. Finally, Gold's gonna get past Nimble here, and as Queen drops for Blue, they're down to one warrior, looking to get their second up on right, and they're successful. Managed to pick up a kill to bring it back down to one warrior for Gold all of a sudden. They managed to, Gold gets a speed up on right. Oh, what a crazy rise kill. Blue Abs just punished that one drop tap. That's all it takes. So we're down to two lives left for each team here. Blue Snail's finally getting back to mid, so it's kind of a reset. But a lot less berries, of course. Oh! Gold Queen manages to fake out Connor, but eventually gets punished later on. So now we're down to last life for Gold Queen. Oh, nice kill. Connor went and chased the ball to right, but Gold Queen was waiting. Sebastian managed to get up two team members up, so it looks like they managed to reset there. Blue Speed looking to get up on mid, but there's warriors there to block it. Their attention was diverted to Snail, so Blue Abs gets back up. Alright, still plenty of berries, still plenty of time. Looks like everyone's up. We'll say that Blue's got two speeds versus the one control. Chasing of the Blue Queen here. But no one's really contesting this snail, so Blue is now getting past mid again. Just a slow tug of war here. Finally, Gold Stripes is trying to escort. Wow, nice exchange there for Blue down by Snail. So now we're just down to one abs. Oh, almost. Yeah, there's two of them. We have a speed drum looking to get up, but still looking for a gate. But a lot of pressure by Blue chasing the Gold Queen. Looks like he'll get up on right. So we've got two. Oh, back down to one again. One speed warrior only for Gold here. He's doing a good job of chasing and just trying to maintain controls, but right's opened up, so look at all Gold back up. And a good scrape by Gold Skull in order to clear up that snail. So, switches again. But still, one of the Blue Speeds just went down trying to clear snail. So now we have another. So, Speed Warrior gets up on left, so they managed to get two speeds back up again. The berries are slowly disappearing here. My eyes are pretty bad at this. I see a few at the bottom, but they're starting to disappear. Oh, Blue just, Queen went down, so now they're both on last life now. Snail is now reset again at mid perfectly, so. Oh, nice bump by Snail there, able to trap the Gold Speed Warrior who goes down. Gold is white. Looks like they might be able to get one up. No. Speed check Blue manages to sweep that. Gold is looking to get back in it, but they're kind of cut off at all stops. So right now it's Blue's game to win here as they have complete control.
One
warrior just dropped. So right snail open. Looks like they'll get a speed warrior following up to get back into it. Meanwhile, the snail's been trucking along, getting down to speed. Looks like they'll get their second warrior up in order to hopefully bring it back. They're running out of time. Sebastian's forced to go and clear it. Now they've got a speed axe down there and riding the gaze. I mean, they have riding the snail. So they were able to stabilize just in time. Oh, what a dive there. Gets punished by the stall there. Unfortunately. And ready, so it looks like we're going to have a repeat on day. Gold with an early play to bump off left gate, but then drops it. So he still gets a warrior up. Yeah, so Blue does a nice job of resetting there and getting their warriors up, so all good there. But Blue Snail's already out of tunnel, making good progress in that commotion. Gold calls those big snails, gets low, manages to escape. Nice bump there by the Gold being able to pick off one of the Blue warriors. Alright, lots of speed action here. It's hard to keep track of. Just a slight overextension by Blue there. Loses to the Blue Skull. Alright, Snail getting back in the tunnel here. Blue looking to get back some warriors. Manages to. Oh, nice scoop there. At midgate. Everything seems to be converging on the right side of the map. Oh, nice get in. Manages to deny the warriors out, but overstays are welcome. Gold Queen slices it up and now opens up left gate. Gets their second warrior up. Snail out of tunnel, looking to get their third warrior. Manages to get it up, so we'll now have everything reset. No lies lost, so no. That's a complete wipe now on Gold with Snail out of tunnel, so let's see what happens here. They managed to get one warrior up. Looks like they'll get a second one as well. They'll have to make do with two for now, looking for another speed drone, hoping to go up. And they get it. Okay, so Gold managed to recover quite quickly. Surprising. Snail is getting slowly towards the net, but has plenty of warriors to rebuttal it. Slightly drops it and loses it. Oh, manages to avoid the pinch there. Somehow got picked off there. Oh, Connor gets punished, drops, flies out of the gate, out of the basket. So Snail coming back out, under doing all that work. Oh, just kind of gets stuck at left gate. Balls there. There's two speed versus one vanilla, but he seems to not be afraid of Skull. Manages to pick up a kill too, even with blue apps chasing him. Nice little footwork there. Wow, manages to somehow bounce off of that pinch for Gold Skull. Doesn't get put down. And Snail keeps moving. Oh, another blue clean kill, so now blue's on last. Surrounded, he stays too long. Gold Queen sweeps through, so it's back down to one warrior.
To go to left
the two gold. Oh, gold speed rises up too fast into the queen. Looks like blue has a good up on mid as a vanilla.
And there's another one got up on left
gate. Yep. So we have two warriors to three. They get the blue gets their third up on that and picks off warriors. Oh, Connor tried to get out but couldn't. So down. Blue's starting to get into the net. Forced to make a play, gets punished for it. It looks like a white for blue here. But the gold slowly creeping in. Skull's waiting on the wrap screen. So they managed to tie it up. We're going to go to the fifth map. That was really interesting to watch. Lots of back and forth. A lot of deaths around the stale. Typical day stuff. So we'll see what the final map will be. I'm guessing it can't be day. I could be wrong. Hear it from the crowd. Game 5 hype. First one of the tournament, I believe. How about there? Well, how many games was there?
Oh, it was 5 games. Abby 2-2 to Chipwash, and then Chipwash clutched last berry.
I was hoping.
He was on last. It was really close.
Okay, so it looks like the final map's going to be on night here. We have the same pattern again. Blue takes high and gold takes low. Both blue. Oh, blue like, hangs around mid too long and gets picked off by gold skull. But blue queen is holding right gate, gets one warrior back up, and you still have blue checkers at the top. Nice kill by Blue Apps there. Nice bounce. But also Blue Queen also goes down at the same time. Another nice kill by Blue Apps. Oh gosh, Blue Apps is just... You guys can tell I'm a fan of Blue Apps. I just keep talking about him, but he just keeps performing. His scrapes are really good. Got a gold skull, just a slow vanilla. Oh, yeah, that's unfortunate. Now Blue's gonna have to play on last versus the three lives of gold. With the gold stripes chasing, but breaks off. So all gate control for gold. Looks like they'll get up on mid. failed pinch attempt there, has a Bull Warrior go down. Blue's holding the top and getting their Warriors back up.
Oh,
good call. Close attempt by Gold strikes it, trying to pick up the win, but doesn't quite get them. Blue quickly down the one Warrior there to get a second one up on left gate. Gold gets their second back up. Breakthrough on top and scrape off the snail, pick up some kills. Recovering on left gate. Oh, almost another, almost a close kill again on the blue can by Gold Strikes. Ah, but he's picked off near the snail. Zone coverage by Blue almost gets bumped. Oh, nice kill by Gold Skull. Able to pick off a Warrior there near Snail. Blue half goes down to Gold Queen, but we just got the one Gold Warrior up. He managed to make a nice walk under the Queen to pick up a kill for a drone trying to go up. Oh, but punishes the second attempt there. So two Warriors back up. More to come. Blue getting the momentum again, despite being down on lives, has the snail on their side of the board. Gold just down to, got two Warriors, but snail is well protected right now by Blue. Trying to walk in, but he gets spotted by Blue Abs. Oh, Queen takes the matter into her own hand and dives into the snail, managed to pick up that kill. Oh, and a pinch for the other Gold Warrior, so now they're back down to one, but then Gold Skull's not deterred. He goes and makes plays. He knows what time it is. They know.
It's playtime.
Oh, such close, and finally gets burned. Skull gets burned there. So, but still, they have one Gold Stripes watching. Again, trapped, and another pinch right in that platform by Snail. So, Gold appears to be white. Nope, they have Gold Abs up. Which again, gets dived down, but has to hold the spot, gets killed trying to walk out of it. So they keep using their Warrior in order to stop this Snail. I don't know if it's worth it, but they let come out. Gold Warrior goes down there. Ugh. Another Warrior gets picked off by Speedgate there, just couldn't hold the stick. Unfortunate. Blue Ab punishes that dive by the Queen, so but still has an extra life that deserves. Still trying to be aggressive. It's critical, I think that's going to be it. So Blue Snail takes it home for the 3-2 beat over Sebastian's team. Wow. Really interesting, just a lot of death under that platform on night. Just trading Warriors for time, and eventually just couldn't put together to bring back the snail out. Alright, that's going to do it for me. Maybe I'll pass it over in the future. Hopefully that wasn't too terrible. See ya.
My soul has left my body.
You guys got terrible comments.
Hey, I was playing
terrible. Like worshiping the comments. play good commentator, you play bad commentator.
Okay. Alright, I lied, so I'm back. I'm gonna go ahead and comment this match as well.
Can people hear me?
I don't know.
I think they can. Yeah, the mic's
on. Oh, yeah,
it
seems like the mic's on. Okay, hi, this is Prashant from New York. I'm commenting Sam versus Vi, two New York teams. Well, the two New York queens at any rate.
The catch is that Sam's team is
as
missing
a
fifth. So
yeah.
We're nicknaming Bot Jeff because that was supposed to be the person who
registered
but not registered.
Yes.
A little confusion there.
Todd did a boo-boo as far as I can tell.
And unfortunately, Sam got the last pick of the tournament.
You know, I don't think it's that unfortunate because I think when you have a bot, they don't miss top berries on dust. They don't miss berries when you're running on meat map. It's actually working out for them. I think their bot is an asset.
Because they have nerves of steel. They're never going to feel the pressure.
Yeah. At least at the start of yesterday, I think, when people were still figuring stuff out, they were making a lot of progress with just a bot. I think people have gotten better at berry running or snail guarding now. So we'll have to see if this pattern continues. Sam's team's definitely going to be looking to try to run berries. I expect Vi to also try to run berries. But let's see how that happens.
On day map, you think that Vi will...
I think they'll run berries on every single map. The problem is that when you're running snail, you need a lot of coordination, and none of these teams have coordination, because we're in a draw scenario. So in this kind of setting, running berries is very powerful, because you get to just go in and fight a lot of 1v1s, and you ought to be fighting 2v1s, and you're not punished for that. So you're able to effectively guard snail, even on day, when you really shouldn't be able to.
Just want to appreciate having some actual people with some experience commenting. All I could do was state the obvious this last matchup, so apologize for that. But relatively new, only have about 1 year in this game.
So Brian Wong is on abs, and Wyatt is on skulls, I think that's right? Yeah, so Wyatt's going to be looking to... Okay, so it is a berry mirror. So Wyatt's going to be looking to try and get established on ledge.
But
and,
already...
Wait, is this a warm-up? This might just be a...
I think it's a. It should be a warm-up. It's their first match, right?
Yeah, it is. It ought to be a warm-up, but it looks like they're playing a real game. So...
We'll see.
Oh, no, it is a warm-up.
It's a warm-up. It should be.
Okay.
Right, I was confused because they did crossover and they're like making some plays.
I was like very confused.
And I'm like saying, wow, they got a really early berry start.
Yeah.
But I can see what you're saying. The bot, I prefer the bot being berry than snail because they just take
100%.
They'll walk on a straight line to a snail. This is so easy to guard that.
Yeah, the advantage of having a human on snail is that they can do bumps.
They can do
and
bumps.
That's much less applicable on berries, actually.
Right, they can switch off the snail if they got a warrior guarding and stuff, and just things that the bot's not gonna do.
And Wyatt actually is holding the empty warrior's joystick, empty player's joystick, so he can control it to snail or berries.
Yeah,
so he's actually gonna flex, depending on the situation.
Interesting. This would be an interesting matchup to see.
I think the big challenge for Vi is that B-Wong and Wyatt are both excellent warriors, and it's going to be hard for Vi's warriors to actually fight them one-on-one.
So what do you think you should do when you're like outmatched?
If I'm Vi, I think you just have to run berries, and you have to say that my berry runner is better than a bot. But it looks like Vi is actually going for snail. I think this is the scenario that I predicted. So Wyatt's going to go right in the tunnel. A more coordinated team would immediately go and flush Wyatt out. But I expect Sam to come and hold that. Yeah, okay. They did get Wyatt, but Sam managed to get a speed warrior for it, which is a good trade. In the meantime, B-Wong's been holding off the ledge guard, so they have three berries at a start, while Snail is still pretty neutral.
Mm.
They get their fourth berry in, Gold's down to a single warrior, and Snail is not going to make any progress.
No, not until they get their warriors back up.
Yeah, but it's going to be hard to actually get warriors up against B-Wong and Wyatt.
They get their second.
The problem is even any warriors they get, they're never going to get a speed.
And they just dropped one on the top there.
Yeah.
Blue abs. Picked that off.
Yeah.
So now I say the snail progress.
If you look at the berry count, it's
it just keeps going
five
up.
In, four in,
and
four left, sorry.
Yep. And the bot never gets tired. It might miss a couple ledges, but berries never come back out.
And so Blue's basically shutting down Gold's warriors. And this is a problem when you're running snail. You're supposed to be winning on military because you have three pieces to do.
Yeah.
But if they're winning on a 2v3, it's very challenging. You can't go into a snail versus berry match when you can't win your 3v2. You have to go to berries and hope that you pick up a kill on Wyatt or pick up a kill on V-Wong and try and snowball that.
That was clearly shown and demonstrated.
Yeah. The disadvantage they have is that their bot is not that efficient at running berries. So if you kill one of them, that's much more meaningful than if they kill one of you. Well, this is a great pick from Vi. Vi recognizes that they're probably at a disadvantage, and I think Meat Map is best at exploiting this. If you're a weaker team and you're playing a stronger team, you probably always want to pick Meat, because no one really knows what to do, and it's pretty chaotic, and you can try and exploit that. They won't have the coordination advantage over you.
Yeah, I did notice in a lot in the group matches that the Meat tend to be a very evenly distributed between wins and losses.
Much more so.
And they'll have a mirror on the berries here, so not doing snail.
So Blue has a ledge set up. Gold does not have a ledge anymore. Sam just killed the ledge. Gold's going to try and get a warrior out, but all gains attack. It's actually quite tough. There's an empty hive for Blue, and this is where the bot is not that painful, because the bot doesn't miss jumps.
Meanwhile, Gold's got to try to get a warrior back up.
Yeah. There's no good path to that, because Sam's covering all the gates right after. Okay, they get Gold abs back up.
It's going to go straight to ledge.
Vi's also on last life. This is going to make it very challenging for Vi to actually help. Yeah, Vi's getting chased. Okay.
Yep. Alright, not getting much comment on that.
Yeah.
Like I said, very clean, just control, like I said, just showing how that bot really doesn't hurt when you can just wipe.
The problem is they're just losing a warrior right out of the open, and then it just totally snowballs, and it's very hard for them to recover from that.
So is that like Violet should be looking to like hang around and support safe in order to like get their warriors up? Is there just the warriors are just dropping off too early?
It's hard to say. I think Vi probably should
be
trying.
I think technically this is not illegal, and they're not supposed to be able to pick the same map.
Yeah. Oh, why is this not legal?
It's supposed to be. You only can pick a different map after three maps. So like pick a map that's been played before. I thought that was my understanding.
We haven't played Night yet, I thought.
We played
Day and Meat.
You are right, and I am colorblind, so I'm gonna.
Okay. So this time we're again seeing snail versus berries. Let's see if this theory plays out. Blue was running some snail there for a second. I guess they hadn't set their bot up yet.
They managed to still get quite offset for a bit.
Yeah. Gold is trying to run snail back. They were up to three warriors for a second. Gold has a ledge guard set up. Okay, nice.
Yeah,
so that's a lost warrior left, and Sam's probably going to pick that up. Okay, the warrior at least escapes. That's good for Gold. He can keep ledging.
But he's kind of stuck on the platform there.
Yeah.
A little bit of nerves there.
I think, okay. I think this is just the story of B1 catching Vi off the ceiling, and it's hard for Vi to play him.
So that's like just a tech mismatch, or
yeah.
Just...
Yeah.
I have similar problems, too, where I just notice... going to like playing against New York players, it's like a much different skill level. And
right.
It's just the window for like the tolerance of pixels is just, it's crazy. It's razor thin. You must be perfect.
Yeah.
Or you will be wiped.
If you're less experienced, it's just the warrior has a whole bunch of options you don't consider on how they can get to the ceiling before you. And so you think you're safe hovering in midair, but you're not, and then your hard sticks aren't that perfect.
Yeah, I think I've been playing, when I was playing matchup against Connor in one of the groups, I would give him so much respect on Dusk, even though there was such a large gap, I wouldn't go for the dive at any point. As a Vanilla Warriors, I'm just like, he's going to sweep back up.
Yeah.
And he almost anticipated me as an unexperienced player to drop down.
But that means that Connor is exerting all of his pressure by just existing. Because
yes.
He's making it so that you can't dive, even on places where maybe you ought to be able to dive.
Yeah, it's just I don't have the confidence that I think I'm going to lose that matchup. So I'd rather at least keep the ceiling from him. But you're right, just that skill level gives him so much more room to maneuver.
Yeah.
All right.
You know who's up next?
I'm not sure. I can pull up the schedule. I don't even know which cab they'll be on. It looks like the other one might be finishing up as well. standing ovation by other team.
Yeah, I wonder what happened.
Five.
Trying to figure it out.
Well, there should be just one more match left. Kevin versus Moose.
And BK versus Christian. Okay.
That might already be happening on Capital.
Maybe that's what people are cheering for.
Yeah, because BK just finished.
BK with a narrow pin on Christian. So BK has to play Shipwash next. I think that's favorite for Shipwash.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Do you know what scene BK's from?
New York.
New York? Okay.
But Travis and Steffi are OG, and Callie is quite new, so BK might be outmatched at Warrior.
Yeah, I'm, 2022? New school.
Yeah.
Are you an OG as well? Have you been playing? How long have you been playing this game?
I've been playing since 2016.
Okay, great. Yeah.
So a while now.
You can now divide it up, pre-pandemic, post-pandemic.
Yeah. There's been a lot of new people who've been struggling in New York post-pandemic because before there weren't really good public cabs in New York.
Uh-huh.
People played in either the Google office or NYU.
Okay.
And now we have a cab in this bar called Wonderville, and this bar has been picking up after the pandemic. So there's a lot of new people who've been playing in this bar.
Question, what are the hours? How long do you guys get to play? How often do you play, and how late is it open?
So on Wednesdays, we have a draft-ish tournament in Wonderville, and that's going to go from like 8 to like 10 or 11.
Uh-huh.
And then Tuesdays is slightly more structured, where we play in NYU, maybe from 6 till 9.
Okay.
And then every now and then on a Saturday or something, we'll have try-hard sets for like 12 to 3 or 12 to 5. Where people who are practicing for tournaments will bring teams in.
That's really good. Right now, like the Baltimore scene, we'll meet twice a week on Wednesday and Friday, but both 2-hour sets.
Yeah.
So feel like it's limited there, and they're not really like tech oriented. They feel like a trash game. So
yeah.
As for me, like I noticed that like I need to change my tapping structure after this tournament. Like I can't change it now, but like I need to significantly find something new. I need to dedicate some time. Like let's just drill, or I just need to like
tapping.
Yeah, just tapping.
Do you single tap?
I single tap. I can double tap, but it's not consistent, so I'm
right.
Like, do I risk that?
Yeah, not in a tournament, but after that, it's very worth it.
Yeah.
Between 2018 and 2019, I switched from single to double, and it made me a lot stronger.
Because I'm noticing, like, yeah, I had the hard stick down, but now I just don't hard stick as fast as the other opponent.
Yeah.
And so, like, that's the next level I need. Now, I was like, yeah, I can hard stick, but slowly.
Yeah.
And the other Warriors are just winning those battles.
Okay. All right, so we're seeing DC Billy versus Sebastian. My money's on Sebastian for this one.
I would have to agree as well. Sorry, Billy. We love you.
Do you know DC Billy?
Yeah. So I was, I kind of live between DC and Baltimore, so
okay.
I would at some point just like travel back and forth. They've kind of had a recent cab change
right.
That moved a little bit farther away to like Virginia, so now it's more primarily Baltimore.
So I guess based on where Sebastian is and what picks he was able to get, he feels confident running three Warriors, and so they're going to try Snail. It looks like this is actually a Snail Mirror. I'm pretty surprised that so many teams are trying a Snail Mirror in this format. I figured everyone would just want to run Berries. Gino and Richard pick up a Snail Guard. Richard gets picked up. I think Sebastian plays fairly conservatively. So I am scared that when his Warriors die, he won't be able to get them back up. But so far, it hasn't been a problem, and Snail's pushing for gold.
I wonder if that's a psychological thing, because in trash games, we tell him he's too risky, and now he's like, oh, I'm in Terminus, so I need to be conservative.
Maybe. What I want to see someone do, if you're pushing Snail, you need to control mid-gate and control that platform and post a Warrior up where gold stripes is.
Uh-huh.
And that lets you control Snail off the rope. Right now, Blue can actually pop Snail like that. They shouldn't be able to.
Uh-huh.
If Sebastian were to just wait above mid-gate until Snail's off the rope,
right.
His team would just be able to push Snail onto that platform. Now he can think about rotating a bit more.
But I think they're kind of reacting to a wipe here, right? And
that's
now
true. But I feel like, and maybe it's different in this format, but my sense is that letting people have slow Warriors
Ooh.
Is not that bad. But
a nice attempt to bump the
yeah.
to Queen, but gets punished.
Yeah, DC Billy's scrambling to get Warrior as well. Snail's going in.
Looks like he'll get one up on mid. I mean, he needs to stay up there.
Yeah. It's very hard to do anything useful in a position like this because you have to move immediately. Okay, but they get the Warrior kill.
Yep. And they're bringing it slowly back out.
So, Richard's the last Warrior alive for gold, and Gino's trying to get up. Okay, Gino gets up. They have two.
A casual walk under
nice
the...
Nice pick up from Sebastian. So, Blue has one Warrior left, and Snail's rolling in. It's really hard to recover. Okay.
Have Blue Skull.
So Richard and
but immediately goes down.
To go under that platform,
and Blue Abs go down. So now it's a wipe, and I just think this is going to be it. Yeah, I think Billy was able to get some Warriors back up, but they just immediately ran like into stationary Warriors.
Overextension. The problem is that even if you get one Warrior up, what you need is that one Warrior and the Queen to come in tandem. If that slow Warrior is coming alone to try and make a play on the Snail, they're never going to succeed. Because it's the odds are too overwhelming. You don't have time to like set something up carefully. You just have to go. So you need someone to come in and cover your head. And I guess let's talk about Dusk for now. But I think the big mistake that I saw from Billy is that he should have come in and helped that one Warrior when they were fighting with Snail and not gone for a second Warrior.
At that point where the Snail was like so critical.
Yeah. Almost a bump from Gold. Again, it's a Snail mirror. Richard's very good at these, but he dies immediately, so maybe not that good. So Gino is left, but Gold has a ton of gates. Like, the right gate was open for the longest time. I have a feeling Gino's not going to struggle that much to get out. Oh, sorry, Richard's not going to struggle that much to get out. Richard's taking his time to get speed. I think that's the correct choice.
Yeah, especially if they're not pressuring the gate so much, yeah.
Yeah. Gino with a nice hard stick. What I want to see is if... Okay, so unfortunately Blue didn't have any speed Warriors, and this is the struggle when you're down on speed, is your slow Warriors get bullied a lot on Dusk map. We have a term for we call that slow prison, when all your Warriors are stuck at slow, and you don't have a clean pathway to get speed, okay. Since you don't have a drone that can get speed.
They have Blue Skull,
Richard,
but it doesn't matter.
Blue. Yeah, okay. Yeah, it's very hard to make a good impact as a slow Warrior versus two or three speed Warriors in Dusk. I'm actually not sure if speed is valuable on meat though. I haven't figured it out yet. I think slow might be pretty good on meat because speed feels very out of the way for me to get. It's a berry mirror.
It's a berry mirror, yeah. A 2-1 open.
This is what makes meat degenerate. Interestingly, even though it's a berry mirror, Blue is going a 3-1 berries. I don't really like that. I think if you're doing berries, you should just do 2-2. You'll be outcompeted if the other team gets to run two berries every time they get a clear, but you only get to do one.
I guess they're just thinking they're military outmatched.
But this is the same thing that happened, right? Look, Blue ran two successful rounds. Gold ran two successful rounds. Gold has four berries, now five. Blue has two.
Nice kick in, but doesn't manage to get the other one in.
Yeah.
So they get some of the bottom berries in, but the...
Yeah, but the important ones in the back are...
right, and it's being ledged, yeah. Meanwhile, you need five left on the gold side.
Yeah, Gino forced out the gold ledge guard. So, or the blue ledge guard, so Blue's not able to ledge right now. Oh, and gold is running berries from behind the hive. They have some speed berry runners. So they snuck some berries in from the back.
So they're down to two. One's accessible from the bottom ledge. Technically, the other one was speed.
Okay, one last, one left. You can't get it from the bottom, but this is pretty rough.
Yeah. Oh, but manages to follow it even after it was killed.
This pattern happens so much on Dusk, where you, or not on, on meat, where you kill the berry runner, but the berry drops into the hole anyway.
And that was because it was, they had no more horizontal momentum, and it was a completely top-down kill.
Yeah.
I'm
gonna go take a look anyway.
up. So, Rashawn stepping off, thanking for his experience and comments. I'm pretty sure we're going to do it.
It's a little faster. Yeah.
Sorry, what was your name again?
Billy.
Billy?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm Jesse.
Nice to meet you. I don't think we met. I haven't been to DC in a bit. I mean, I haven't been to Baltimore in a bit.
Oh, okay. You're DC, Billy?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I used to come up here like every single week.
Nice.
We're doing double
John the whole time. What's up? Hey. This is the double elimination bracket with Abby and Christian. We got Abby on blue and Christian on gold.
Both teams down in loser's bracket, but they went to game five against their opponent, so should be a pretty good game.
Yeah, we got Christian getting a warrior up middle. That's Abs. Who is Abs? Who are these people? Let's find out who the teams are. Steve Parker's up. Christian with the early berry lead.
It looks like they have their
Abby with the gate control. Sorry.
Looks like they have more warriors up there for gold right now, and they're controlling the berries. Oh, they have some number of warriors, yeah.
Yeah.
Warriors, yeah. Oh, that's a death there, so even again.
Christian seemed going for the double ledge early.
All right.
Ooh! Abby nice. Goes down.
That was Julia getting
nice.
That pinch
nice.
With Christian. Oh, there we go.
Christian returns with an Abby kill.
All right, so Barry and military lead for Christian.
Yeah. I played Ooh. Abby. Abby was my first game today. We went to game five. Their team is solid.
Yeah.
I played Christian in pools. Their team is solid as well.
Yeah. They went game five against BK's team. So
They did.
Pretty even tournament for the most part.
Yeah. Oh.
Oh, and that's the first game for Christian.
That was a bit bop boop.
Bit bop boop.
A little pinball. We don't have any pinballs here, but that was like a pinball.
Oh, there's pinballs over there.
Oh, we got pinballs.
Yeah, there's pinball. Strike that from the record. There is pinball.
I'm not really a pinball player myself. Actually, what's wild is like I've been playing pinball a little bit at a glitch, just whenever people make me, and like I do better than some of the pinball players. And they're like, "You don't play?" And I was like, "No, I kind of find it boring," and then I just walk away. And then I realized how like, what's the word? How kind of rude that seems. How kind of like. Because I'm like, I don't really like pinball.
Yeah, it's just like that's the only thing. Yeah, it's fine, you know. I don't know. I feel like the fact that, like, I could get into the pinball, I just haven't, you know, because, like,
yeah.
I do kind of like the idea that, like, it's like a video game with a lot of physical parts. It's like a very custom kind of video game that, like, it's not just, like, a joystick and a monitor.
Yeah.
So
it's a game where you play yourself. So it's like, it's like saying I'm really good at solitaire. And it's like,
yeah, that's
Christian with the turnaround right off the start.
That's the thing with me, too. Like, I feel like I want games where there can be strategies and counter-strategies. But
yeah.
Whereas, like, high-score games, you're just, like, you're playing by yourself and then comparing how well you did by yourself.
I don't even play single-player games anymore. I have to play games that are online or, mm-hmm. or you know, couch games where I can play against real people. Just because that's
I can do co-op, too, but...
Ooh!
Ooh, all right, Worth.
All right, Queens are even on lives.
Okay, looks like it's a little bit of a berry lead for
yeah.
Christian
Snail's
still.
Moving off the rope to the gold side. Oh, no, they stopped that real quick.
Oh, did they double knighting?
They were going to do a split strat, but up blue nest is open. Thanks to, who is that?
Yeah.
This text is so tiny.
Who are you looking for?
Blue Abs.
Blue Abs is Sam, yeah.
Abby with the kick away.
Yeah.
She's coming to take away some more gates here. Christian with his... fast tap. Like, Christian's got probably the fastest tap here.
Mm-hmm.
At least out of the Queens. I don't look at all the Warriors, but...
He should compete to be the Tug of Peace champion.
Yeah, he's definitely got... Todd is actually really good at that as well.
Really? Okay.
Yeah.
It's his daughter's game.
If we play two hands, Todd beats me. If we play one hand, I beat Todd.
Okay, but what do you mean by one hand? Do you mean, like, one hand, then you involve the other one?
So, like, Todd uses three fingers on his left hand and then two on his right.
Okay.
To play. I actually, when I use two hands, I use three fingers on my left and then my index finger on the right. That's how I do that. So he's actually got one more finger on me, so that's how he beats me there.
Okay, so you can just win with just those three fingers. You don't got to use that one extra finger, though.
I mean, I tried adding an extra finger in, but, like, I just don't have the pattern.
Okay, yeah.
But then the swipe, the claw, I win every single time. I can even let him have his two hands, and I still win with it.
Okay. Is the claw not allowed?
I mean, I don't know how it's not allowed. That's how I won the fastest tap in
okay.
What was it, EV4?
Yeah.
Yeah, I got that trophy. I remember whenever Troy did it, and Troy got, he tapped all the way up to 69 and then stopped.
That's good.
Actually, I got disqualified twice from that tournament.
Uh-huh.
Because you can only use one hand, and I'm so used to doing two hands. Last tap, I would slam it with my other hand.
You're not used to, like, the artificial restriction.
So, yeah, that one was definitely one hand only. They did have an official ruling on that.
I like that this tournament, we're starting to develop, like, meat metas now. Like, instead of everyone just being resigned, you're like, no one knows how to open meat.
Yeah, this is the most competitive meat map we've had, and I still don't really know exactly how to do it. Like, and in South Florida, we've been trying to get people to encourage them to, you know, how could you have your pudding without finishing your meat? You know, you gotta play your meat map.
Oh!
No dessert until you finish your meat.
All right, looks like Christian's up now.
Yeah. Christian's team's running some hard berries. That snail's not going anywhere, but both queens are on second life.
Yep. There's just a tiny bit of berry and snail lead from gold, so it's kind of neutral.
Oh. Yep. Blue queen, get out of there.
Oh. Spicy.
Up.
I think they're all out for blood now.
Little dancey dance. Little rap dance in there. Oop, got one. That's big.
Hidden berry. That was
sneaky. That's big.
Sneaky. Crouching tiger, hidden dragon. Big.
Also, blue's starting to pull that snail. Oh, this could be the... Oh, yeah. I saw that. Little sneak attack. Little rat poaching there.
Okay. Yeah, these warriors are thirsty.
Oh, yeah. That 3-1 snail's looking really good. What's actually interesting about running snail here is you can see that little nook above the snail? Yeah. That warrior should have went in the nook.
Yeah, he should have went in the nook.
As soon as you get in that nook, that's where you want to be.
Gold Stripes needs the nook now, too, but maybe they're just waiting until a threat comes.
Yeah, probably. But, like, you're an immovable object, and it's so interesting because no other map has that.
Yeah.
From both sides, at least.
Yeah, I really like playing with that nook in on Dusk as a warrior, because lock down the snail and then play the... Okay.
Anyone's game now. Both queens on last.
Whichever one of them does something silly first.
Gold has 5 more berries left, but that snail is a threat.
All right, Christian's feeling silly right now. I see him.
Hey, you can see it in his gameplay.
You can see it in his eyes. He's got that silly look. Okay, here we go.
Here comes the silly.
Okay.
Going through the wrap, stopping that, yeah.
All right. Oh, there we go. And that's 3-0 for Christian. So Abby is out of tournament. Christian advances.
Tough run.
Good games.
Yeah.
All right, we've got Rob versus Keith coming up here in just a moment.
We are skipping this match, to be honest with you.
Were you skipping Rob versus Keith?
Yeah, for now.
Okay.
Because Keith is not here right now.
Okay, cool.
Robert.